Okay, here they are, the band that's brought you the hits for all these years, LA Zone Dickies! Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you! Thank you! Thank you, 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 thank you. And it is not too redundant of me to say at this time, thank you. This is the song that made us stinking rich. Hello, hello, hello. Any better?
Check.
Okay, you know.
Wait a minute.
You know, a lot of people have been asking us from show to show. They say, Leonard, why are you so popular with all the young ladies? What is that sort of animal magnetism that you have that draws ladies to you like flies to a dog turd? Did you make some sort of deal with the devil? I want to state for the record right now, we've made no deal for the devil, or even with the devil. And we were thinking just a few months ago how nice it would be to do a song about devil worship. Stan and I were barbecuing a baby by the pool, and it dawned on us that we couldn't really come up with a song about devil worship on our own, so we re-ramped an old one, and we're going to do it now, and it's called Knights in White Satan.
Just attempt it. I don't need any room. Come on, let me in. don't know anymore.
I love you. Because I love you. Because I love you. Because I love you. Coca-Cola! This song is called You Try Me, Eh? You Big Gorilla! An oldie but a moldy. It's on our first album and it's called Give It Back.
Yeah, you gotta back.
Brother Bill, Stuart. I know.
All right, man.
Take your time.
Okay. You know,
okay. This song is off our second album, and it goes like this. It goes.
Yourself. No hope, there's fake or bad. There's facts I have to learn. So many things I want to do. Especially to the islands of Paris and Italia. Fascist and Spaghettia. Please just be everything, yeah. Without an obligation, as they got back.
Okay. Oh, for me? Thank you. All right, this song, it's also on our second album, and it's about a very professional lady named Trisha Toyota.
My TV, my favorite show is about to begin. As I was getting across the town, so I hit the dirt, and I could burst out. Then I put you there, put you to cry out.
Are there any questions? Later, actors, later. I'll remember you two as long as I live. Okay, well, that's appropriate enough that I found that out, because this song is kind of a warm love ballad. Oh, England. Yeah. Yeah, they're trying to remind me of England. Anyway, I want everybody to kind of take off your clothes and grab the person next to you. And light up a Dini and Rossi, and dance to the strains of Walk Like an Egg.
I'm just a lonely egg, building down, I'm not afraid. Hey, I wanna know now, what will you do? I'm asking you, what will we do? We'll be right back. the food and living and I'm a lick. Coming down and I'm a riding day. But it seems that I'm the good.
Baby, when you did it, talk about you. Pop a bit around. Ain't the big town. Send it to the water. Send it to the water.
Okay. How many people here tonight think that the lyrics to our songs are sexist? Well, Stanley and I wrote this next song in order to appease those people who just raised their hands. You know, a lot of people have been telling us, hey, you know, you Dickies, you're fun, you're entertaining, you're just great guys, but you don't do any songs of any social relevance. Where are the songs about the starving people in Ethiopia? And where are the songs about, you know, the social condition of man? Well, Stan and I had tried to correct that situation, and we wrote this next song. It's rather new. It's about a really ugly girl with really big bazongas. And it's called Cross-Eyed Tammy. Okay, this song is about one of our American founding fathers. a man who made this country great. It's going to be on our next record. And it's called The Saga of Jim Bowie. This next song is about someone very near and dear to me. That's right, I'm talking about my dick.
Don't forget the introduction.
You know, my dick is important to me. I think if it weren't for my dick, I wouldn't have the motivation that I have. I want to wear the same size pant size that I wear now. I don't even think our band would have the same name if it weren't for my dick. Now my dick, thank you, another satisfied customer, ladies and gentlemen. My dick has a name, and whether you people know it or not, your dick has a name. Your dick doesn't have a name, I know that. I know, you don't have one. They all tell me that.
I don't have one.
My penis's name is Stuart. And this song is called If Stuart Could Talk.
Well, he says, Stuart can talk to me.
as I walk. Well, now what will he say? Staring at my cupid. My cupid. What would he say? What would he say? What would he say? Shit. And you know, Leonard, there's really something I think I gotta mention. Every time you look at a boy, my eyes stand right up at attention. Look at that. Look at that. Look at that. What? Look at that.
Okay, this song is about one of my favorite actors, a man who's real big in the showbiz world. Talking about a man of strength, talking about a man of conviction, I'm talking about a man of warmth, I'm talking about a man named Barney Rubble. Oh yeah! Oh yeah, you guys know him, right? Is he the greatest actor that ever lived, or what? Bedrock, wherever you are. And if I could do my bowling with anyone, I'd do it with Bedrock Barney.
Party, party. He likes to party, party, party.
is called Manny Mo and Jack. This guy right here is the greatest human being that ever lived. He's a guitar player extraordinaire. He wrote every song we ever did. He wrote every song that the Beatles ever did. Why, he even wrote everything I'm saying right now.
That's great.
If it weren't for him, the universe would never exist. And this song is...
Dickies!
Dickies!
Come on!
You don't want
to. Dickies!
Oh, gentlemen, the Dickies.